Hi, my name is Dr. Audrey Lewis. I am an audiologist at Dallas Ear Institute, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about earwax. Everybody has earwax. That's the first and foremost thing that I want to talk about, is that we need to have earwax in our ear canals to help pick up debris from our environments, like when dust falls into our ears from wind blowing, or to also make sure that we do not collect fungal, bacterial, or yeast infections in our ear canals. So wax has a really big job in our ears, and the main thing is that we don't really need to get rid of it. A lot of people feel like it's a cleanliness thing, that they have to get that wax out of their ears, when in reality, that needs to be there. So you can put the Q-tip down and just let your ears behave the way that they need to. Just like you don't typically need to take the mucus out of your nose, you don't need to take wax out of your ears. So if you do end up having a large amount of wax in your ears, it can be frustrating because it can cause a fullness sensation and sometimes temporary hearing loss because the sound is not able to travel to the through the ear as effectively. In those cases, it might be necessary to do a little bit more to help your ears clean that out. A few do's and don'ts of earwax removal. Don't stick or shove anything into your ear canal. Do not use Q-tips, chopsticks, pins, bobby pins, toothpicks, ear candles. Those things are actually more likely to cause trauma to the ear canal and eardrum, or to shove wax down to the eardrum, than it is to actually help take things out. A few things that you can do at home is, the first thing that I like to do is just allow warm water to flow into my ear when I'm taking a shower. And this kind of helps clear out debris and helps kind of keep that wax fluid. Another thing that you can do is use mineral oil or baby oil drops into your ears. So you'll turn your head to the side, put a few drops into your ears. You don't need to fill up the ear canal, just a few drops. Let it sit for about 3 to 5 minutes, and then do the same thing to the other side. If those things don't really work very well, then you can move on to a few over-the-counter options. The first is going to be something called Earwax MD, and this comes with a little dropper as well as a water irrigator for your ear. So you put a few drops in, let it sit, wait, and then use that small little irrigator to kind of help get out some of the wax or the debris. Another thing that you can use is something called Debrox. This is really common over the counter. You're probably more likely to find this in your local store. It is also very good, once again, putting drops into the ears of this kind of oiled hydrogen peroxide mix and letting it sit. It might crackle, it might bubble a little bit, it kind of feels really weird, but it does help alleviate some of that wax buildup in your ears. Now, there are times in which seeing a physician is a good idea if you have wax in your ears. A few things are, is if you've tried these things at home and you still haven't been able to clear the wax, do call a physician. There's a lot of things that we have that we can use to remove that wax, such as curettes and suction. When you have pain associated with the fullness, a foul smell, or any kind of drainage that looks infected or like pus, in those cases, it is important to seek medical attention. Otherwise, your ears are self-cleaning machines. There's really not much that you need to do about that. So be well, take care of your ears, and if you need medical management of those ears or wax or any kind of thing going on, please let us know. We can't wait to hear from you.